editors who rage quit a job without thinking. What was the last straw? I was working at a call center. My shift started at 10. I badged into the building at about 9:55 and logged on. But the decrepit PC I was using took so long to boot up that when I finally logged in, I was 15 seconds late. I told my supervisor, and he said there's nothing he can do. Since I was late, I was put on probation and wouldn't be eligible for a raise for another month, and that I should arrive 15 minutes early so that situation won't happen again. I handed him my headset, walked out, and have never worked in a call center since. I need a summer job while in high school, so I applied at a local grocery store to bag/stock/clean. My first day there was some sort of confusion as to what I was supposed to do or to whom I was to report. I was sent to the front counter where the customer service manager gave me a till and told me to open a register. Mind you, I'd had zero training on a register. I didn't even know how to put the till in it, for crying out loud. I told the lady this and was told to go do my job. Within about 2 minutes at the register, there was a line several deep, and I'm just standing there with the till in my hands. The customer service lady comes storming over asking why I had such a line, and I tried again to explain to her that I was supposed to be a stoker or whatever and that I knew nothing about operating a register. She called me stupid in front of the customers, so I handed her the till and told her to go screw herself. Walked down the street in my uniform and got a job at another grocery store. Went through several interviews and started a new gig. I'd be providing call center support for Windows, maybe some Apple support. Nothing I couldn't handle. I am, after all, it's support. Hell. I even cleaned the mouse while trying to take the technical test. I get a start date and I'm told it'd be 2 weeks of training. No big deal. I can do 2 weeks of training. I show up on day one of training and it's support for Whirlpool washing machines and dryers. Hold the freaking phone. What? That's right. Classic bait and switch. I got up, walked over to my hiring manager and said, I quit. You hired me for Windows support, not washing machines and dryers. And walked out. 2 weeks later, I get a call. Hey, this is your manager. I'm calling to find out why you haven't come to work in 2 weeks. I guess you didn't get that memo. I quit on day one. Because your company lied to me. Got an $80 paycheck. About 7 years later, I got a letter in the mail that a class action lawsuit had been filed against the company for labor law violations. 2 months after that, I got an 8-cent check in the mail. I giggled. I worked as a painter for a franchisee of a student painting company, and he kept telling me that he would pay me next week. This went on for about 6 weeks, and the final straw was when I had finished several large projects that would give him ample money to pay me, but he decided to hire on another person instead of paying me for all the work I had already done. Like $1,300 worth of work. Then he tried negotiating down what he thought he should be paying me, despite already having agreed in writing what I would be getting paid right from the get-go. I was so mad that I didn't give him notice or even show up for the next day of work, because I had bills to pay and needed to make as much money as possible during the summer. I wrote him off as a lost cause and took him to small claims court for what he owed me, and eventually got my money through the court. Still was a pain in the ass though, and as far as I know, he's still working there full time. I was 21 working at UPS. Was a truck loader the first year. Became the fastest loader in the warehouse, just because I like working quickly. Only wanted to become a supervisor because my manager was really easy to work with and always wanted to help with solutions to problems. Once they promoted me to supervisor, they transferred my manager to a different warehouse and didn't say why. Worked as a supervisor for a year, and once peak season arrived, mid-November, early January, things were getting crazy and my manager was just a yes man to his boss. Never helped solve issues, just said figure it out or just get it done. Well, in November, my best friend and I had won a World Series of Beer Pong Satellite Tourney to get a free entry and stay at the Flamingo in Vegas for the tournament worth $600. Tournament was from Jan 1st 5th. Well, during peak season, it's nearly impossible to get time off, and I looked at this tournament as a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity with my best friend. Things were just getting so crazy, and they weren't approving any vacation requests. I wasn't getting assistance from my boss with the workload, so I just said screw it, I'm out. Come to find out, my manager, his boss and four other managers got fired for changing time cards to make their production's numbers look better. Which I found out is why they shipped my cool manager away, cause he wouldn't participate in the dirty deeds. My best friend and I placed 46th out of 500 teams. It was one of the best memories I have to this day. No regrets. I used to work as a housekeeper at a really shady hotel. Wasn't the best job in the world, but the pay actually wasn't that bad. The owner and his wife were horrible to everyone, especially the housekeepers. I eventually worked my way to being the head housekeeper, but they kept referring to me as a maid. I don't know why that bothered me so much, but it did. Anyway, the rodeo was in town and we were really busy. I had every single room to clean, and none of my other housekeepers were showing up for work. So I asked my boss where they were, and he said he gave them the day off. They're young and have stuff to do. They were all high schoolers, and I was 19 at the time. It was summer, so he decided he wanted them to go out and have fun and leave the 65 rooms to me. I was already mad at that, but then it got worse. I get to about my 15th room, I'm exhausted, and I just want to get one more done, so I can take a break. I knock on the door, no answer. So I let myself in, only to see a man standing naked in the doorway. I apologize and try to leave, when he calls me back. He said he wanted me to clean the room. I told him I couldn't, while he was still there, and certainly not while he was naked. He said I had to do it, he was a guest. I go to my boss and explain why I wasn't cleaning that room. He told me I had to do what the customer said. If he wanted to be naked and in the room while I cleaned, then that's what had to happen. I threw my cleaning rag at him, told him to screw off, and left the rest of the rooms to him. I worked as a stock boy in the back of Hollister, clothing retail for those unaware. Never really had interaction with customers, but was still forced to buy their clothes to wear to work. They had all these rules about hairstyles, fingernails, and facial hair. One night I came in to start a shift at 2:30 a.m. to do a floor change, so middle of the night, and the shift would end around the time the store opened up. I had the slightest bit of stubble on my face, like a day and a half's worth of stubble. My manager, at 4 a.m., told me she had a problem with my facial hair, and that when the mall opened up I better go buy a razor and shave. Before anyone saw me like that, she would have to send me home for the night. I basically said, well, lucky for me, I was planning on quitting anyways. Good luck with the floor change, and walked out. Went and got a biscuit breakfast, went home, and got in bed. Earlier in my career in residential HVAC, I thought it'd be a good idea to branch out a little, to add some tools to my tool bag, so to speak. So I took a position as a lead installer at a smaller company. It wasn't particularly bad, it just wasn't in my wheelhouse, and I grew to dislike installing, and tried to shift back over to the service department. My manager knew I wanted to transfer, but wouldn't let me despite my prior experience, and instead hired another tech. Now, part of the reason I didn't want to do install anymore was because of the salesman. They were idiots. The concept of a tape measure was completely lost on them, and there were times they'd overpromise at the expense of me and my assistant. One day in particular, the residential salesman had us install the wrong type of evaporator coil, makes the cold happen, in an attic without taking any measurements beforehand. It didn't fit between the joists, and when I asked for someone to come help, I was told to use your imagination. We managed to get it done, sort of, but at 5:30 it literally fell apart. I was apoplectic, called the salesman and unloaded on him. We hacked it together just enough, and we left. The next morning at the shop, the salesman tried talking to me, and I quit on the spot. He said that we had a meeting with a Lennox rep and to reconsider. Please just think about it. He must have thought I agreed, because when I went to turn in my timesheet in the meeting room, he began to introduce me as the lead installer and service tech when it's slow. So I look at him and reply, PSH, I freaking was. And walked out. Boss not doing payroll, before leaving on a business trip, and leaving it to the poor office manager to tell people they weren't gonna get paid on time. I walked out of the staff meeting saying I'd be back when paychecks arrived. By the time I got home, I was mad enough to call my ops manager back and quit. Why didn't the boss do payroll? Stated answer was printer toner cartridge at home was empty. Guess he never heard of writing checks with a pen. My first job in aircraft maintenance was for a grumpy old dirtbag. I was a completely green apprentice fresh out of school, and the old bastard had no understanding of what his obligations were when taking on an apprentice, and expected me to just already know everything. He'd send me to do jobs unsupervised, wouldn't provide any instructional guidance, then get upset if I messed something up. He chewed me out for taking too long to do stuff. He'd occasionally call me into his office and quiz me on random shit, then belittle me for not having all the answers, telling me he was going to phone up his buddies at the college and tell them how disappointed he was with the quality of their graduates. Guy was a total hypocrite too. Didn't have current manuals for any of the aircraft, didn't properly track parts and hardware. He literally had a room full of random spare parts with no history, and took all sorts of shortcuts. One time during a windscreen replacement, rather than measuring out the hardener for a sealant, he eyeballed it. It was supposed to set up in a couple hours, but it hadn't hardened after 3 days, so he made me paint over it. We were supposed to cut open and inspect every oil filter we replaced, looking for metal that could indicate a failing engine. He'd store all the old oil filters on a giant workbench without labeling them, then after a year or two go inspect them all at once, if any had metal. There was no way of knowing which aircraft it came from. He got away with being shitty because the Transport Canada inspector responsible for audits in that area was a friend of his, and he'd boast about how audits consisted of them bullshitting over donuts in the break room for 3 days. Anyway, it was the last day of my probation and he called me into his office to tell me he had a very difficult decision about whether to keep me on. I told him I'd make it easy for him and quit on the spot,